Hey guys,
we're back for another Alex Terrible video.
I don't even want to talk right now. I just want to get into this.
All right, so let me just line it up. Alex Terrible, System of a Down cover, Lonely Day.
That's probably one of my favorite songs.
And let me just say, he's becoming quickly with Radio Tapok are my two favorite Russians of all time. Of all time.
Really?
Of all time. And I was a huge Gorbachev fan. Of all time. I don't know. Maybe it was because the island on his head or something. I don't know. I really dig him.
What Yeltsin. What about Rasputin?
Oh. Okay, Rasputin number three.
Russia's greatest love machine.
Number three. These two guys are slightly ahead. First of all, one makes great covers. And the other one not only makes great covers, has his own band. And looks like he could beat me up in a corner of a building.
See, I'd love to see pay-per-view match. No, pay-per-view match. Alex Terrible versus Thomas from Wolfheart.
In a Russian slapping contest. Oh, make it rain. Make it rain.
I'd pay
big bucks. I would pay big bucks. All right, you ready for this?
I'm ready.
His clean vocals are amazing too. Wow.
Dude. When the video started, I'm like, who the hell is this guy? Because I haven't seen his real face yet.
Oh, because the previous videos he had the mask on.
He only had the mask on.
Oh, shit. Yeah, you're right. He had the mask on. That not even went into my mind.
Who the hell is this guy? And then I hear him singing and I see the tattoos on him. So I know it's him. And then he has the mask in hand.
I love this guy.
This guy's awesome.
I love this guy. I can't believe we've gotten so late to the party as far as Alex Terrible is concerned. I really have to thank Galactic Criminal because he's a huge reason why we even checked him out. Because he's been pimping him out to us for a very long time. I feel like we're late to the party, but not that we're here. Let's partay.
Exactly.
You know, we're not going to stop by doing just one video here. We're going to do a lot more of his stuff. And Radio Tapok as well. We got to do more of his stuff. I just love these two guys, but this guy, he's funny. Yeah. He has a good sense of humor.
The drinking of the coffee. I knew there was going to be more after the drinking of the coffee and he drops it. And then after he bites a sandwich with like everything came out. And he looks so sad.
Real first world problems, yeah. I must say.
When you bite a sandwich, but the whole sandwich just leaves you.
How many times has that happened? When you're eating, especially when there's multiple stacks and you try to squeeze at the front to fit it in your mouth and then everything just falls at the end. It happens quite a bit, actually. So it's not far-fetched. But what did you think of this cover?
I mean, this is one of my favorite songs from System of a Down. So yeah,
me too.
Any cover of this, I'll take like very seriously because I don't want anyone ruining this song. But this guy, I mean, he can do no wrong in my books. And even though the song itself, for it to work with these vocals, he'd have to like push up the guitars and everything and make everything a lot heavier. But even though he didn't do that, he just went full on vocal cover. It still sounded pretty good. It
sounds amazing. I like the fact that he finished off at the end with a little bit of clean
vocals.
With the
clean vocals, that was really
he kinda
nice.
Hinted, there was a part where he kind of hints like he's going into a more softer approach. He doesn't have that deep approach anymore. So he kind of hints that maybe there's something coming in. And then he hits you at the end, which really shows how good of a vocalist. Both styles, his range is just incredible. Now, when I see him walking around singing like this, I'm like, is this what Wolverine would sound like if he had a metal band?
Yeah.
I don't know why. When I look at him, like, he's a big dude.
He's
I
kind of Wolverine. There was a Wolverine movie where Wolverine had a brother, and he kind of looks like Wolverine's brother in that movie.
I think he looks like Wolverine, period.
I'll show you it.
Wow, it's like, wow, if Wolverine had a death metal band, this is what Wolverine would sound like. That's what I get. To me, Alex Terrible is the Wolverine of the music scene. He's the Wolverine of the music scene. Like, the guy is, like, he's fierce.
Monster, yeah.
He's a monster. He's a monster. Like, dude, I don't, like I said, we're so late to the party, but I, you know, but now that we're here, we're not going anywhere. I love this guy. I love his voice. I love his approach. I love his persona. He seems like a real fun guy, like really down to earth, fun guy. That to me adds a little bit because these videos are, there's always a little bit of comedy in them. It's not like it's just the cover. There's always a little bit of comedy. I like that aspect of it because he obviously doesn't take himself overly too serious. You know what I mean? And I love it, man. Like, the darkness that he brings was really interesting for me in this song because this is a song that's very emotionally driven by the message in the lyrics. And in the original, I always felt that you feel that emotion coming through. When Serge is singing, you kind of feel that loss, that empathy with that loss really comes through in the way he sings, in the way he...
But he's not just the one singing in the original.
I know, but I'm saying, like, the way he sings...
It
has that. Going into this cover... I really feel like he kind of captured that a little bit. Because I don't know if you noticed, when he's walking around and he's singing, he's not just singing.
His
facial expressions were kind of changing depending on the lyrics and at what part of the song he was in. So there was a little bit, there's a little bit of going back to the roots into how the original song is done and bringing a little bit, bringing some of your own experiences into this song, into the lyrics, into what this song represents. Because this is a track... I think everybody who listens to this song sees this song or listens to this song from their own personal experience, from your own personal things that you're going through. And now during the pandemic, talk about lonely day. I mean, it's a different kind of lonely day. We're all having lonely day. Every day is
every
a lonely day,
day. Every day is a lonely day.
So we're all having lonely days. So that, in my opinion, hits home even a little bit harder. So this is a song that you can listen to it and you can perform it and you can cover it and bring your own... interpretation of what that lonely day means to you, because the original interpretation is there, that's fine, but I think from his perspective, the way he was performing this song, I think there's a little bit of his own lonely day in it, if you know what I'm saying. You could see it in his facial expression when he was singing it. But wow, this guy, man, hands down, like,
yeah.
Mic drop. Every song is a mic drop. I don't know what else to say. I love this guy. You know, I've never felt like I needed to go to Russia as much as I feel like I need to go to Russia now.
I mean, we were basically in Russia.
We were close.
We were very close.
We were stone's throw away, you know. But man, fuck. This guy's incredible. Incredible. All right. On that note, guys. Let us know in the comment section. Because I'm having a hard time going through the whole YouTube channel of Alex Terrible. And is there any hidden gems in there?
Yeah.
Like, just hit us up in the comment section. What are some of the hidden gems on his channel that we should definitely be checking out? hit us up, all right? Let us know in the comment section, okay? And we'll see you tomorrow at another video. Take care, guys.
See ya.